Hi there. Welcome to my life. Or should I have said, welcome to my past life. Although, I am not so happy to know that I would come to the point where I need to tell you how my life had been before my death, which, surely, you wouldn't even become interested at all. I would rather think of the silver lining that, somehow, a lesson lies in it after all. Have you ever come to the point where you were suddenly tired of living? No. Existing? Like trying to find your essence because you're here instead of making an essence because you're here? Did you get me? Have you ever just gotten tired like you don't want to breathe anymore and bang, you're shut down? Well, as much as I would like to sugarcoat things up, I just can't. Let me show you, but please promise me you would not judge me. My dad used to become a very successful businessman. He owned a well-to-do factory of rags, and he used to supply the best doormats and hand towels across Metro Manila. Maybe that is the parody of his life. That what made him really rich is what give him bed sheets and covers right now. His rags. We were all okay. Me, my brother, until one day, my mom suddenly shut down of cardiac arrest. My dad, he was never prepared. He had terrible days coping up, like he lost interest with his job, lost interest with us, drowned himself with alcohol and drugs, and just suddenly lost the interest of living. Now here he is. As miserable as hell. Oh please, it's too early. Don't be fed up. We are just starting. Now let me also tell you something about my pony brother. He is the frat cool guy, and his name is Vincent. You know what is so consistent about him? He never failed to make me feel how small I really am. From the way I talk, to the way I walk, to the way I carry my books, to the way I smile. He thinks I am just nonsense. I just came to the point where I got tired of pleasing him because I love him. And I just want to stop making him feel that way towards me. This was my life. For 20 years, all I felt was I was always struggling. You can never imagine what I am feeling. I know, because your existence is too good compared to mine.
Okay, class, for you, what is the meaning of life? Nikki, you're late again.
For 20 long years, I was asking myself why I were here, when everyone around me doesn't want me. Why were I here when everyone else sees me as an object? I know I'm not supposed to find reasons why I exist, but how do I seek essence when everyone tells me I'm senseless? Even my family, who's supposed to be there for me all the time, says the same. Even they hate me. Even they feel cursed because of me. I tried. I swear to God, I tried to live alone for myself. But I just can't. For 20 years, I tried to justify that life was a blessing. For 20 years, I tried to exist. And yes, it was definitely just a try. I don't know why this is called life after all. Isn't it that life is supposed to be living? But why do I feel otherwise? I wish someone out there is capable of showing me how to deal with this. But no. All of them hate me. All of them sees me as a piece of entertainment, a piece of sponge to absorb everything. At least, can somebody tell me which place to go to feel home? Because I don't have a home. This empty space is suffocating. The darkness in this place gives me little holes to grasp for air. This vacuum feeling, although is alienating, is at least capable of making me feel safe. Can I just stay here? I like this pain. It gives way for some blood to spill. The blood that constantly runs in my veins, and the very reason why I am still here. The blood that gives more joy to people, their soul, their key through me. And while this blood skips my system, I feel free. I am free because people surrounding me are losing their toll to hurt me. I feel that somehow I take revenge because I inflict a pain more than they do. I feel free. This is the only time I feel responsible for myself. I feel myself becoming finally dependent on me, even temporarily. But I ain't feeling okay. I never felt okay. Why are these wounds healing so fast? I am so fed up. I am fed up of feeling fed up. I am really tired of being myself. I wish I were on somebody else's body. I feel so sorry for myself. And I wish I could stop feeling sorry for myself. This is my life. They could have saved me. But they did not. Life is not really fair. It isn't. Now let me tell you something really interesting.
Death.
I might have escaped the cruelty of man surrounding me, but offing myself did not really help me figure out why I ever existed. Ironically, I am still lost right now. I can't tell it really helped me at all. But you know what I never regretted? It is that, at least right now, I am all alone. I am responsible for myself. People can never belittle me because I'm out. I am out permanently. If ever I get lost again in this journey, at least I know I cannot blame anybody, because I never get to live for somebody else's expectations. This is my life. I wish that it were different. I wish this is somebody else's story. I wish people could have done something different to save me. I wish my life... were like... this. This is how I wanted my existence to be. If I can ever exist again, I will choose it to be this way. I will choose people and another Nikki who are strong enough to strive for an existence like this. Would I have been happier? I don't know. Nobody knows. All I can say now is, I'll see you all when I see you.
Oh, you.
When the days are cold and the cards all fold and the saints we see are all made of gold. When your dreams all fail and the wounds we heal are the worst of all and the bloods run stale. I wanna hide the truth, I wanna shelter you, but with the there's nowhere we can hide. No matter what we breed, we still are made of greed. This is my kingdom come. This is my kingdom come.
Oh, you.